when we look through the Word of God and through the Scriptures, and we see, you know, God created the animals, He created the waters, everything that's in the water, the sky, the birds in the sky, and etc. We think, oh, you know, it's awesome. It's part of God's creation and things of that nature. And, you know, when we look at animals right now, whether you have one at your home or not, like for me, I have a parakeet, I have a bunny. What else did I used to have? I used to have a cat. So it doesn't matter whether it's a house pet or the animals we see in National Geographic or in the zoo. We tend to kind of look at them, oh, that's cool. You know, it's an animal with unique characteristic traits. And, you know, we can pet them. We can buy them. We can huddle them. We can hug them. We can have them as pets, however it may be. But for me, in recent years, I began to look at animals in a different perspective and say, let me take a specific animal and learn about it and see what kind of leadership characteristic traits and principles, valuable kingdom principles that I can take from this animal. So today I want to talk to you about the imperial penguin and what I like to call the imperial penguin principle. And I want to share this very interesting fact and how we can apply it into our personal life and to our spiritual growth and especially to you as individuals, a leader. So here's the fact that during cold winter season, it's mostly dark and no sun to keep the males warm. So typically what happens is the female, she lays the egg and the male stays with the egg and then they go out they're searching for food, which takes more than 100 days before the mama comes back home. So during those cold winter seasons, it's very dark. So what is the leadership or the spiritual principle and takeaway can we learn from this specific fact that as they're able to endure these cold, dark winters, just like any organization or any church, you know, you'll have your dark seasons, which are problems, setbacks, financial setbacks, issues, you know, people leaving the church, church splits, however it may be, just issues in marriage, however it may be. You know, amongst, you know, individuals, amongst husband and wife, amongst team members, amongst leaders, that these type of dark situations that do rise up, they will come. That's not something that we can avoid. But as long as we work together, we're going to give each other a beacon of light and some hope. And what happens usually, typically during these cold winter seasons, that these penguins, they huddle together and they keep each other warm and they actually keep an eye on each other. So whenever, you know, in your family, your marriage, your ministry, your business, your local church, whenever you go through these tough and dark seasons, what you need to understand is as long as you work together, as long as you shed the light of Christ and the Word of God by saying, hey, brothers and sisters, hey, honey, hey, kids, however it may be, hey, co-workers, we'll make it through this dark season. Yes, it's harsh. Yes, it's cold. And even right now, as I make the recording of this video, it's the year 2020, and we're still, it was a year of a major pandemic, and, you know, everybody experienced it in a different manner, in a different way, some to an extreme degree. Some, you know, not as much, but overall everybody's affected. And the question is, only when we come together as the body of Christ, only when we come together as a husband and wife, only when we come together as an employee and employers, as we work together as a team, as an organization, as one unit with one focus and vision, then we'll be able to bring some hope during these troublesome seasons whether your church is going through, your marriage is going through, or your business, or however it may be. So I believe, one of the powerful facts and takeaways that we can learn from this awesome animal is that they learn how to work together during this cold, stormy season until obviously the sun came out as the season changed and became warmer. And always understand, dark and cold seasons are not meant to be last forever, because our God, our Heavenly Father, who's also brings that light just as much as He brought the light in the midst of a dark desert to the Israelites, He will likewise bring light, hope, and warmth into your family, into your marriage, into your business, into your local church, into your ministry, whatever it may be. Okay, my friend, hope this was a blessing to you. Until next time.